like to talk to the HR professionals that may be dealing with someone that's suffering from depression. So let's say someone comes to you and they're presenting with, you know, you kind of recognize that their mood is a little bit lower. Maybe potentially their performance has been maybe decreased, and you're recognizing just a change in temperament. Maybe if the person's more extroverted, they're more introverted, or if they're introverted, they're more extroverted, and you're concerned. So what do you do as an HR professional? So obviously, you need to kind of have a conversation with that individual to talk to them about just that you're concerned about them. And obviously you could, you know, talk about a little bit about what you're seeing with them, and just as a, in a friendly manner. But ultimately what you want them to know is that you care about them, and you've recognized that maybe there's been some concerns just around the issue of productivity. What you want to let them know, reach out to them and talk to them about what's, you know, how can you help them as their manager or the HR representative? What is it that you can do to help them? So you really want to elicit something from them in reference to what's, what you can do to help them. That said, if someone starts to get into personal issues, you're going to know you can listen for a bit, but ultimately what you want to be able to do is to refer that person on. If there are actual skills that they're needing, or tactical things that you can help with, or just, you know, helping out with reference to skill deficits where they can, you can help them gain a skill, obviously that's something you can do. But if it becomes something a bit more personal, at that point, you really have to be open to say you, that you, obviously you care as, you know, as an for them as an individual, but also on behalf of the company. And at that point, you should be, you know, open to having them, you know, giving them a number or letting them, you know, have access to an EAP program, which is basically an EAP program, which most employers have them, is basically a confidential psychological service that individual can use, at which point then you just leave it. What would make sense, the third point, is to just follow up with them in about 2 weeks or so. And you're obviously going to be looking at how are they performing, how do they seem, and you're just going to touch base with them and say, how are things going? If there's no issues around performance, you know, that means that the person is taking care of themselves, those types of things. If the performance issue obviously continues at that point, then you're going to be looking at maybe, you know, having more talks about, you know, the element of making things a bit better and how you could help them then. And it could be end up being something where you're going to be talking to them a bit about more performance-related concerns. So a performance-related issue, not in a punitive way, but to help them along. And then ultimately, I think the main thing when someone's struggling with depression, the main thing is that you let them know that you recognize that it's a tough time, you're here to help them in any way possible. So I hope this is helpful. If you have any questions about how to implement strategies in reference to depression in the workplace, please reach out to me at RoxanneDurHodge.com. Thank you and have a great day.